All right. So, Happy New Year. What an awesome way for at least me to start the new year. And I really appreciate y'all joining, and I appreciate you all joining us throughout the year. Lisa and me, I saw Lisa briefly. We have about half of us in this class, and gosh knows how many other people I know tangentially touching COVID. So our three kids were here and went home, and two of them promptly tested positive for COVID. We went to see my parents on the day after Christmas, and my mom has COVID. But I just talked to my dad, and they're, knock on wood, they're doing well, but just wild. And so, but here we are. And like I like to say, I mean, roll out of bed, roll out your mat in the safety of your own home. So it's awesome. It's great to see you all. Got this book a few years ago, Yoga 365, and I'm going to read the New Year's Day reading from this before we get started. It says, "Begin in stability. We build a yoga pose from the ground up in the same way that we would build a house. First, we build a sturdy foundation, and then we construct the floors, walls, and roof on top. Without a stable foundation, the structure will not be strong and enduring. Similarly, you need to construct anything in life in this manner, whether it is a friendship, a business, or a creative endeavor. When you begin any endeavor by first establishing stability through communicating, organizing, and goal setting, you give yourself a solid basis on which to build for the future. The next time you embark on a new relationship, job, or project, create a stable base from which to grow. Begin in stability." Okay, we're going to start in Sukhasana, easy seat. Many of you probably are already there, legs crossed. I have the block. Sometimes when we're just kind of sitting here, sitting on the block helps because it elevates your hips. So I'm sitting on the block. It feels pretty good. And legs crossed is not comfortable for everybody, especially if you have super tight hips. So if you had your feet together, soles of your feet touching, still your legs open, you kind of achieve the same thing. And I'm not going to repeat the story because so many of you have heard it, but I'm going to be we'll begin with a breathing exercise. And I'm going to guide that. And so let's sit up nice and tall. Let's draw our shoulders up to our ears and then draw our shoulder blades back down our back. If it is comfortable for you, close your eyes. And maybe set an intention for this class, for this hour, for this weekend, for the week or month or year ahead. A lot going on in the world. Perhaps send a positive intention to someone who comes to mind for you. And we're going to take five deep cleansing breaths. I'm going to cue those. And as you inhale, bring in all your hopes and thoughts and dreams for this coming year. And as you exhale, expel anything from the prior year that you'd like to make sure stays behind you. We'll do this five times. Big inhale through the nose. Hold. Big exhale out of the mouth. Big inhale through the nose. Hold, big exhale out of the mouth. Big inhale into the nose. Hold, big exhale out of the mouth. Two more times. Big inhale. Big exhale. Big inhale. Big exhale. All right. Pranayama breathing is a form of yoga. We're going to do one more breathing exercise, very simple one. So open your eyes if they're not already open so you can see what I'm doing. But put your hand, it doesn't matter which one, make a five out of it. Fingers spread wide. This is called starfish breathing. It's a great little breathing exercise. You're in traffic and you're tense, or you have a grandchild or a young kid who gets upset. Great little calming exercise. So take the index finger of the opposite hand and bring it to the base of that thumb. And it's starfish breathing. So we're going to inhale up the thumb, exhale down the thumb. Inhale up that index finger, exhale down that index finger. Inhale up that middle finger, exhale down that middle finger. Inhale up your ring finger, exhale down your ring finger. Inhale up your pinky, exhale down your pinky. Okay, if you were sitting on a block or pillow, let's remove that. We're going to start moving. And we're going to remain in this cross-legged position or soles of the feet together, whichever is better for you. Again, let's sit up nice and tall. Start to incorporate some movement with that breath. Take our arms out wide. Let our arms sink down to the mat. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, arms out and up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, arms out and up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Okay, here we go. Inhale, arms out and up. Exhale, open your arms, twist to the right. Inhale, back to center, arms up. Exhale, open your arms, twist to the left. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, open your arms, twist to the right. Last time, inhale, arms up. Exhale, open your arms, twist to the left. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Let's take our left hand, put it on our right knee. Let's take our right hand, put it on our left knee. Sit up nice and tall, straight as you possibly can. We're going to fold forward with our breath. Inhale, exhale, draw yourself forward a little bit. Inhale, exhale, draw yourself forward just a little bit more. Inhale, exhale, just a teeny bit more. Maybe you have just a little bit more. Inhale, exhale. You probably feel that in your hips, maybe your lower back. And then let's come back up to seated position, upright seated position. We'll take our arms out wide again. We'll bring our fingertips down to the mat again. We'll inhale, arms up. Now we're going to hinge at the hips again. So you are going to hinge towards me. And when you can't fold forward anymore, let your hands come down to the floor. That might be barely in front of your legs. That might be way out there. Everybody's different. Hands touching the floor. Let's crawl our fingers away from us. Kind of deepening that stretch. And then we're going to crawl our fingers over to the right. And we're going to crawl our fingers back to center. And we're going to crawl our fingers over to the left. And we're going to crawl our fingers back to center. And then we're going to crawl our fingers back towards our body so we can be back where we started. All right, we've been sitting here for 10 minutes with our legs crossed. Let's open our legs, let our legs go long. Maybe shake them out if our knees are a little bit rusty. And then we're going to lean back on our arms. So you're going to have your right hand about a 45-degree angle behind you and your left hand about a 45-degree angle, like you'd sit just comfortably on the floor. Now, bend your knees, draw your legs towards you, weight on your heels. We're going to do two different twists here. The first of these keep these these feet hip width apart. And as your legs fall to the right, try to keep your upper body stationary. So don't let your upper body go with the twist. Just let your legs fall. Probably see mine don't go very far at all. And then come back to center and let those legs fall to the left. Same thing, try to keep your upper body stationary. And then back to center. And then we're gonna do that again. Take your feet a little bit wider than your hips. All right, this time in this twist, allow your upper body to go with the twist. So to try to get your legs as close to your knees as close to the floor as you can. So twist over to the right and try to get that left knee down as close to the floor as you can. And then back to center. And we'll go the other way. And back to center. Let's come back up to that seated position. We're going to do one more twist here, and then we're going to shift over to our hands and knees. So let's take our left hand to our right knee. Take our right hand to that same position behind you. Sit up nice and tall and take your gaze over your right shoulder. And then come back to center and switch hands. So right hand, left knee. Left hand behind, sit up nice and tall. Take that gaze over your left shoulder. And come back to center. And we're going to transition over onto our hands and our knees. So the first thing we're going to do, and we're going to be here for a few minutes. So if you need a little cushion under your knees, that's perfect. That's a great thing to do. A lot of people like to fold the mat to double the width of the mat, but we'll be here for a few minutes. So get as comfortable as you can. The first thing we're going to do is put ourselves in tabletop position. So that is knees hip width apart. That is hands shoulder width apart. That's tabletop position. Let's do several rounds of cat and cow. So inhale, face extended long. Tailbone tucked. Exhale, round your back, chin to chest. Inhale, face extended long, tailbone tucked. Exhale, round your back, chin to chest. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Two more times. Inhale, face extended long, tailbone tucked. Exhale, round your back, chin to chest. Last time. Inhale. Exhale. All right, come back to a neutral tabletop position. Keep your knees where they are. Look down on your hands. Move your hands one hand length forward on the mat. So your arms were straight up and down. Now they're a little bit more angular. And then lower yourself down onto your forearms. All right, this is called puppy pose. We're going to do a little flow from here. So before we do that, let your head come down between those forearms as low as you can. You kept your hips high, so you can see why this is called a puppy pose. And from here, we're going to push away with our hands and stand up on our knees. Yeah, okay. Now, here we go. Arms up, high overhead. Open your arms, twist to the right. Arms back overhead. Open your arms, twist to the left. Arms overhead. Hands to the mat. Return to that puppy pose. All right, everybody knows what we're doing, so let's do that again. Lift away, arms up high overhead. Awesome. Open your arms, twist to the right. Arms back overhead. Open your arms, twist to the left. Arms overhead. Let's do that one more time. Hands to the mat, head to the mat, puppy pose. One more time, push away, arms up high overhead. Open your arms, twist to the right, arms overhead. Open your arms, twist to the left, arms overhead. Hands to the mat, head to the mat, push your hips back so you can be in a child's pose.
Child's pose is an awesome yoga pose. It's an inversion. It is always appropriate pose to take at any time during a yoga class. It can be resting or active, and I'm going to demonstrate that. This should be resting right now. Let your arms be heavy, no tension in your arms. And then let's come back up to hands and knees. Look down at your knees and take your knees wider than your hips. Keep those hands more forward like they were when we did that puppy pose. So you're pretty angular here. Push away with your hands, lower your hips back between your heels. So this is a very active child's pose because those arms are straight and engaged. You probably feel that in your shoulders. I certainly do. All right, we're going to do a little bit of a flow here. So what we're going to do is pull ourselves all the way forward, belly and chest on the mat. Our hands are under our shoulders. Lift your chest and your shoulders, little cobra pose. Lower your chest and your shoulders. Roll it back to a child's pose, keeping those arms straight and long. Let's do that two more times. All the way forward, belly and chest on the mat. Lift your chest and your shoulders. Lower your chest and your shoulders. Roll it all the way back, child's pose. Last time, all the way forward, belly and chest on the mat. Lift your chest and your shoulders. Lower your chest and your shoulders. Roll it all the way back to a child's pose. All right, relax your arms again for this to be a resting child's pose. Then come back on your hands and knees. Knees are still wide. Arms are still toward, hands are still towards the front of the mat. Take your right hand to that upper right corner of the mat. Take your left hand, put it right on top of that right hand. Push your hips back towards that left heel. Get left side body stretch, maybe left shoulder. Then rise back up. Take your hands to that other corner, left hand on the corner, right hand right on top of your left hand. Push your hips back over that right heel. All right, let's rise back up and let's put ourselves back in tabletop position. So that is knees are hip width apart, hands are shoulder width apart. Okay, take that right leg, extend that right leg long behind you. Take your left hand, extend it in front of you. Lift that right foot. This is bird dog pose. Stretch. Right foot back. Left hand forward. Really stretch. And then come back to tabletop. So that right knee is back on the mat. Take that left leg. Extend that left leg long behind you. Take your right hand. Extend your right hand in front of you. Lift that left foot. Stretch. Bird dog pose. Really stretch. Back to tabletop. Got a few more things we're going to do here on our hands and knees. Take that right leg, extend that right leg long again. Lift that right foot, cross it over the left foot. Take your gaze over your left shoulder. Look at your right foot. Come back to tabletop. Take your left foot, extend your left foot long behind you. Lift that left foot, cross it over to the right. Take your gaze over your right shoulder. Look at your left foot. Come back to tabletop position. And we're going to do a sequence called thread the needle. So again, you're in tabletop position. Knees are hip width apart. Hands are shoulder width apart. Plant that left hand firmly. Raise that right hand up to the ceiling. Take your gaze up at that right hand.
Then you're going to bring that right hand under your chest and across to the left and lower your right shoulder down towards the mat. If your right shoulder doesn't meet the mat, which mine does not, I'm using my left hand to help support that weight of my head. All right, we're going to do this in a flow. So here we go. Rise back up, open it up, right hand to the ceiling. Right hand under your chest and across to the left. Open it up, right hand to the ceiling. Right hand under your chest and across to the left. And back to a tabletop position. So that which we do on the right, we need to do on the left. So plant your right hand firmly. Raise your left hand up to the sky. Take that gaze up at that left hand. Get that hand up as high as you possibly can to start. And then we'll thread the needle. So left hand under your chest and across to the right. Same thing. If your shoulder doesn't meet the mat, mine does not, use that right hand to help support your head. And then open it back up, left hand to the sky. Left hand under and across to the right. And open it up, left hand to the sky. And left hand under and across to the right. One more time. Open it up, left hand to the sky. Left hand under and across to the right. Come back to a tabletop position. We're going to do two more things before we transition again. First of those is just push your hips back for a child's pose, a resting child's pose. So allow your upper body to be as heavy as you would like. Let your arms be relaxed. Then we'll come back to tabletop. We're going to keep our right knee bent. We're going to lift our right foot up towards the ceiling. So try to keep your arms stationary as you lift that right foot up to the ceiling. And then return that right knee to the mat. Do the same thing with the left knee. Lift that left foot up to the ceiling. Just imagine you're going to touch the ceiling, the bottom of that left foot. And then we'll do one more thing. Come back here to tabletop position. This is called fire hydrant. So you're on your hands and knees. Lift that right leg straight out to the side. And then draw circles with that right knee. Big and slow. In whatever direction you're going, change direction. And then come back to tabletop. We'll do the same thing with the left leg. Lift that left leg straight out. Excuse me, left knee out. And then draw circles with that left knee. And then change directions. And return that left knee down to the mat. Come back to a tabletop position. We're going to transition to standing. We're going to get there through downward facing dog. We're going to do two downward facing dogs in this class. So here comes the first one. Tuck your toes and lift your hips. Downward facing dog. Okay, again, first of two. Your goal in a downward facing dog is hips are high, head is low. So many people, I'm one, need to bend my knees to push those hips up. Pushing away with my hands to lower my head. Great thing to do is what they call walk the dog. So bend one knee and then bend the other knee. Definitely okay to be moving here. And then come to stillness. Inhale,
exhale, inhale. As we exhale, let's walk up to the top of the mat. And when you get there, let's come into a forward fold. So it's okay to walk up there upright and then come back into the forward fold. Forward fold, head heavy, neck relaxed, arms heavy. Again, definitely okay to have the knees bent a little bit. Really, our primary goal here is heavy upper body, more so than straight legs. And then as slowly as you would like, let's come all the way up to a standing position. Okay, everybody's here. I always am a little bit nervous when I'm doing that, and I've so much of that time on hands and knees, and I can't see. But everybody's standing up, so I think everybody's still with me. That's great. All right, so come up to the top of your mat in mountain pose. So mountain pose, feet are hip-width apart. You want to engage your quadriceps by drawing your knees up towards your hips. Let's roll those shoulders like we did before. Roll those shoulder blades back down our back. We're going to rotate our arms externally so the inside of our elbow is facing the front of the mat. So January 1st is an appropriate time to explain the meaning of mountain pose. This is, imagine yourself on top of a mountain. The wind is blowing 40 miles an hour, and you've got to hold your position. That's what we're doing in this position. All right, inhale, arms up. Exhale, open your arms, twist to the right. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, open your arms, twist to the left. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, open your arms, twist to the right. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, open your arms, twist to the left. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Let's come back to the mountain pose. Inhale, arms up. Right hand, grab your left wrist, bend to the right. Back to center, switch hands, bend to the left. Back to center, goalpost your arms, gaze and face to the sky, arms up back overhead, hands to heart center. We're going to do that exact same thing with our breath. So here we go. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, bend to the right. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, bend to the left. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, goalpost your arms, gaze and face to the sky. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Okay, we're going to do three different variations of a sun salutation. Two of those are going to be half salutations. So we're going to start with a half sun salutation A. So start in your mountain pose. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, flatten and straighten your back. Sometimes that's called a halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Let's do that two more times. Turn your mountain pose. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, flatten and straighten your back. Exhale, fold. Inhale all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. One more time. Start in your mountain pose. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, flatten and straighten your back. Exhale, fold. Inhale all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Okay, we're going to do one full sun salutation A. So here we go. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, flatten and straighten your back. Plant your hands, step your feet back to a high plank. Okay, in this high plank, your back is straight, your core is engaged. One or both knees supporting your weight is fantastic. So no problem there at all. Inhale, exhale, inhale. Lower yourself all the way down to the mat. We were here before.
Hands are under your shoulders. Lift your chest and your shoulders. Lower your chest and your shoulders. Tuck your toes. Roll it all the way back. Second and final downward facing dog. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Walk back up to the top of the mat. Stop in a forward fold. Inhale all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Okay. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, bend your knees, sink your hips, chair pose. Your weight is a little bit back on your heels. Your arms are super strong. Chair pose. Throw your arms behind you. Lower your chest to your knees. Ski jumper. Back to chair. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale, flatten and straighten your back. Exhale, fold. We're going back to chair. Inhale, chair pose. All right, we do that same sequence again. So inhale, exhale, inhale, arms behind you, chest to your knees, ski jumper. Inhale, back up to chair. Inhale, exhale, fold. Inhale, flatten and straighten your back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Are we going to do one more little variation of the sun salutation B? Half sun salutation B. Twist variation. So start in your mountain pose. Inhale, arms up high overhead. Exhale, chair. Lower your hips, bend your knees. Okay, bring your hands to heart center. We're going to take our left knee down to our left elbow, down to our right knee. Take your gaze up at that left, right elbow. Unwind that back to chair. Hands to heart center again. Switch sides. Elbow to knee. Take your gaze up at that left elbow. Unwind that back to chair. Beautiful. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale, flatten and straighten your back. Exhale, fold. Inhale all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Okay. Let's see here. Come to the top of the mat. Start in your mountain pose. Step your right foot straight back as far as you can. You're forced to bend that left knee. All 10 toes are facing the front of the mat. Your right heel is off the mat. Arms up. All right, this is a high lunge. Okay, we're going to take our hands down to either side of that left foot. Let your right knee come down to the mat. Take just a moment to get that left foot and that right knee as far apart as you are comfortable. Again, that right knee is on the mat. More deeply bend that left knee. Sink into those hips. Walk your hands back, straighten that left leg, fold over that left leg. This is a runner's lunge. Walk your hands back forward where you started and rise up on that right knee. So, football coach. Yeah, excellent. Okay, arms up high overhead. Open your arms, twist to the right. Arms back overhead. Open your arms, twist to the left. Arms back overhead. Hands back down to either side of that left foot. All right, we're going to do a few more twists here. So plant your left hand. Raise your right hand. Right hand back down. Plant your right hand. Raise your left hand. Beautiful. Left hand back down. Tuck your right toes to get your right knee off the mat. you're a runner at the starting line. Okay, this, in my opinion, is the hardest thing we'll do. We're going to rise back up from that position. We're in a high lunge again. Beautiful. Open your arms, twist to the right. Arms back overhead. Open your arms, twist to the left. Arms back overhead. Hands back down to either side of that left foot. Plant your left hand. Raise your right hand. Right hand down. Plant your right hand. Raise your left hand. Beautiful. Left hand down. We're going to step our right foot up to meet the left. We're in a forward fold. Inhale all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Woo! Okay, let's do that on the other side. So, start in your mountain pose. Step your left foot straight back, way back, as far as you can. All 10 toes are facing the front. Left heel is off the mat. Right knee is bent. Arms up. This is a high lunge. All right, hands down to either side of that right foot. Let your left knee come down to the mat. Same thing. Take just a moment. Get that right foot and that left knee as far apart as you can. More deeply bend that right knee. Sink into that hip. Walk your hands back. Fold over that right leg. Halfway split, runner's lunge. Walk your hands back forward. Back where you started. Rise up on that left knee. Football coach. Arms up high overhead. Open your arms, twist to the right. Arms overhead. Open your arms, twist to the left. Arms overhead, fantastic. Hands back down to either side of that right foot. We got four more twists here to do, remember? So plant your left hand, raise your right hand. Right hand down, plant your right hand, raise your left hand. Left hand back down, tuck your left toes, get your left knee off the mat. You're a runner at the starting line. Here's that tough transition. We're going to stand up from here. Back to a high lunge. That's a very difficult transition, I think. Open your arms, twist to the right. Arms back overhead. Open your arms, twist to the left. Arms back overhead. Hands back down to either side of that right foot. That left knee is still off the mat. Two more twists. Plant the left hand. Raise the right hand. Right hand down. Plant the right hand. Raise the left hand. Beautiful. Left hand back down. Step back up to the top of the mat. Inhale all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Woo! Okay, I'm going to get a drink of water real quick. Believe it or not, we are going to do some yin poses in this class. We're almost there. Looks like that water was a popular suggestion. Always okay to do that whenever you need to, for sure. Okay, we're going to start with the left leg this time. Step that left leg straight back. Far back like we did before, and then rotate both feet so they're facing the side of the mat. You're wide-legged. Hands on your hips. Hinge at the hips. Try to keep your back straight. Hinge at the hips. Fold forward. And when you can't go any farther, release your hands down to the floor. By the way, this would be a great place for a block if your hands or challenged to meet the floor. The block brings the floor up to you. All right. Fingertips, hand flat on the floor, whatever works for you. Plant that left hand, raise that right hand. Right hand back down. Plant that right hand, raise that left hand. Left hand back down. Put your hands on your hips and bend your knees to protect your back. Come back up to a standing position. All right, we're wide-legged. We're gonna draw our feet in a little bit closer. So you want your feet wider than your hips, but just wider than your hips. Then open your feet to about a 45 degree angle. Okay. Try to keep your back straight and bend your knees. So your knees are flaring out to the side. Goalpost your arms. Awesome. This is goddess pose. All right, we're going to do a couple of twists here. So pretend you're holding a broomstick between your hands. Okay. And then you're going to bring your right elbow down towards your left knee. But holding that broomstick, you can't go but so far. Try to keep those knees stationary. And then back to a goddess pose. And we'll go the other direction. Left knee, left elbow over to right knee. And then back to a goddess pose. Inhale, straighten your legs, arms overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. Okay. Those of you who have taken quite a few of my classes know I love to do balance poses, stability in the new year. So we're going to do a couple balance poses. It's always okay to hold on to something. It's always okay to kind of be tapping the other foot to maintain your balance. It's a process. So we're going to do two balance poses. First of these, the weight is going to be in our left foot. We're going to bend our right knee, bring our right knee to our right hand. Try to keep your back straight. Try to keep your core engaged. Again, always okay to hold something. Definitely okay to come in and out of it. See if you can open that right leg. And then back to center and back down. And we'll do the same thing on the other side. So we're going to plant our right foot, bend our left knee, bring our left knee to our left hand. Back straight, core engaged. See if you can open that left leg. And back to center. And back down. We're going to do one other balance pose. It's called flamingo pose. So what we're going to do here is our weight's going to be in our left foot. We're going to bend our right knee and bring our right heel just above our left knee. So this is a narrower pose. And then, if possible, we'll raise our arms. Using the arms to help balance is completely fine. Usually helps me to look at something that's not moving to kind of focus on. Awesome. Beautiful. Then come back down to center. We'll do the same thing on the other side. So we're going to plant our right foot. And we're going to bend our left knee, bring our left heel just over our right knee. And then maybe we can raise our arms. And again, holding something is great. Any modifications, anything we do that is getting us towards the balance helps us a lot. All right, left foot back down. Let's come back up to the top of the mat. We're going to head down to the mat. Before you do that, grab that block and have that nearby because we're going to use the block. So grab that block and have that nearby. Come up to the top of your mat. Take your feet out wide like when we did the goddess pose. So they're just a little bit wider than your hips, and you open those feet. We're going to go down to a yogi squat. So inhale, arms up high overhead. As you exhale, bring your hands to heart center. Bend those knees, sink your hips. And we're just going to sink down as low as we can. Malasana, yogi squat. Awesome hip opener. All right. Let your weight come back to sit on the mat. and let's lie down on the mat in a Shavasana pose. We'll take a little mini Shavasana here. Catch your breath. Maybe do a quick body scan. All right, we're going to use the block here for this first yin pose called Twisted Roots. So bend your knees, feet flat on the mat. Put the block or the firm pillow, whichever you're using, in between your knees. And then draw your knees towards your chest. Take your arms out wide, right arm out to the right, left arm out to the left. And then let those knees fall to the right. We're going to hold this for 2 minutes. Those of you who have taken Lisa's phenomenal yin class know that two primary elements of a yin pose are time and edge. So we hold these for at least 2 minutes to allow the blood to get into that deep fascia. And if 100% edge is you can't stand it any longer, you don't want to be any more than about half of that. Legs are heavy. That left arm particularly is extended long to keep that left shoulder on the mat. You could increase this a little bit by taking your gaze out that left arm. The reason you've got that block there is to keep those knees parallel, which increases that twist on that left knee, left hip. Just makes it a little bit deeper. And we start with breathing to establish a breathing pattern. So maintain your breathing here. Got about 15 more seconds here. Okay. Unwind that by bringing your legs back to center. Remove that block, and as a quick counter pose, let those legs go long again for a little brief Shavasana. And then we'll do the other side. So bend those knees, feet flat on the mat, place the block between your knees, draw those knees towards your chest. Let your arms go wide, and then let your knees fall to the left. And again, we'll hold this for about 2 minutes. Again, gaze this time out to the right would intensify this a little bit. Not only are our individual bodies different, but your right, or most of us, our right is different from our left. So maybe take notice of how this might feel different than it did twisting to the other side. And again, we'll keep breathing, being intentional about that breathing pattern. trying to let those legs be as heavy as possible. Trying to let those arms be as heavy as possible. Continuing that steady breathing. We've got about 30 more seconds here. Alrighty, let's come out of this by untwisting. Remove that block. Let your arms go long again. Take another little mini shavasana. We're going to transition into another pose. It's called cat pulling tail. So let's sit up and then we're going to lie down on our right side. So this is going to take me a moment to explain this, but you're going to lie down on your right side. And then lie down on your right side and put your right elbow on the floor, rest your hand, your head in that right hand. So you might lie like this, again, lying on the floor, talking to friends. Take your left knee, bend it, put it in front of your body. Now, this is where this gets tricky, and this takes some work for me. We're going to take our left hand. We're going to reach back. We're going to grab that right foot, cat pulling tail. And then if we get that grip, we're going to pull that right knee back as far as we can. And if you're with me still, you've done it. The other thing you could do would be, now that you've gotten in the position, lower your head onto your upper arm, your bicep. And again, we're going to hold this for a couple minutes. When I've done this pose in a class with people in the class, with a teacher such as Lisa, the adjustment generally made is pulling that right knee back farther. So we got not only a twist here, but also that right quadricep is getting a stretch, maybe that right hip. Hardest part for me is getting that foot. And so I got to contort to get that foot. But once I've got it, I generally can do it. And again, we want to make sure we keep breathing. Other than that tension of holding that foot, we want to try to be as heavy as we possibly can. Now we've got about 15 more seconds here. Okay, we're going to come out of this by releasing that right foot. Let both legs go long, and as a quick counter pose, just roll over onto your stomach. You could rest your forehead on your hands. Just a quick counter pose. And then we'll do the same thing on the other side. So we're going to lie down on our left side. Put your head in your left hand as a starting position. Bend that right knee, bring that right knee in front of your body. And then you're going to take your right hand, reach back, and grab that left ankle, left foot, and then draw that back. Again, you can see why this is called cat pulling tail. And you know, one of the things we constantly talk about in a yin pose is being heavy, releasing tension, but there's a fair amount of tension in this pose. So I think the key is to make yourself as comfortable as you can in it. And you could keep your head in that hand, or you could lower your head down to rest on your upper arm, whichever is more comfortable. We've got about 20 more seconds here. All right, let's come out of this by releasing that left foot and roll over onto your belly again for a quick counter pose. All right, we're going to do one last active pose, a highly restorative pose. We need our block again for this. This is going to be supported bridge. So get your block and then lie down on the mat. Bend your knees, feet flat on the mat. If you're using a block, your block has got three heights. You're going to lift your hips and place the block under your hips, your tailbone, the most comfortable height. Whatever that is, the most comfortable height. This is supported bridge pose. Let your arms be long by either side. And see if you can really be, your body just be completely heavy, completely. Your hips are heavy on that block or that pillow. Your shoulder blades are relaxed and flat on the mat. This is a restorative yoga pose. It's an inversion. So you're getting the benefits of an inversion, head lower than your heart, without, say, a handstand or a headstand. Again, try to maintain that consistent breathing pattern. Really easy to hold our breath in poses like this. We're going to hold this for about 10 more seconds. And then let's lift those hips enough to get the block out from under or beneath us. Let our hips come back down onto the floor. Extend your legs long, arms by either side, palms facing the sky, and we will melt into our mats for Shavasana. All right, wiggle your toes, wiggle your fingers, bring awareness back into your body. Eventually roll over on the one side. And when you are ready, come back up to a seated position where we began. Okay, let's take our arms out wide again. Let's let our fingertips fall back down to the mat. Inhale, arms up high overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. Leave a little space between your palms to symbolize holding your heart. Let's bow our head over our hands to symbolize service to our hearts. We're going to do one last New Year's Day breathing exercise. Inhale, serenity. Exhale, anxiety. Inhale, acceptance. Exhale, resistance. Inhale, courage. Exhale, fear. Inhale, wisdom. Exhale, doubt. Inhale, curiosity. Exhale, judgment. I cannot thank you all enough for joining me this morning. What an awesome way for me to start the weekend, the year, everything. I appreciate you all so, so much. The light which burns inside of me honors the light burning inside each of you and your families. Namaste.
Happy New Year.
Thank you, Aaron.